Hello, welcome to this particular module. This module is really interesting because if you recall the last lab component, we were discussing each and every or most of the parts within a PVD system, and when we talk about PVD, we were talking about thermal and e-beam evaporation, right? Now, you should understand and remember that for thermal evaporation, you cannot evaporate a material which has a melting point close to the boat melting point or the source holder melting point, either it is coil or boat on which you will load the source which you want to melt. So, the source material should not have melting point close to the source holding material, which we call as a boat or a coil. Why? Because otherwise that boat or a coil itself will start melting, and that is what we do not know, that we do not want, correct. So, in this case, if the melting point is extremely high, we will go for electron beam evaporation, because in that case we will be using crucible, right, and then in the crucible we are loading the source material that we want to evaporate. Electron beam will come and it will scan the metal or a material, and it will heat the material, it will deposit the it will melt and deposit the material on the substrate. So, how this whole thing works, what vacuum pressure you need to understand before you change it to the high vacuum valve. There is a certain procedure when we operate a vacuum system. There is a rough vacuum, there is a back vacuum, there is a high vacuum that you need to open, high vacuum valve, after you attain a certain back vacuum. So, this we will be discussing in the lab class, alright. Just to quickly help you out, Pirani gauge is a gauge that can be used for vacuum around 10 raised to minus 3 torr, while panning gauge can be used for vacuum around 10 raised to minus 6 to 10 raised to 7 minus 7 torr. Here we are not using the oil pump, but we are using turbo molecular pump. If you have attended any thin film physics class, then you will understand that there are several kind of pumps that are used to create vacuum, including oil pump, Gator iron pump, turbo molecular pump. And each pump has its own pros and cons. Recently, all these vacuum systems or thermal evaporation systems, e-beam systems, sputtering systems, they have the thermomolecular pump to attain the high vacuum, right. So, please focus on this module. This is my favorite modules, because actually you will be able to see how the system is in a operating mode, and you will see how the substrate is loaded, where is the e-beam, and you cannot see e-beam actually, but where is a crucible, right, and there are four crucibles, and then where is a boat, right. So, how the chamber looks like. So, whatever we learn in theory is one thing, when we look something in the lab or we experience that in the lab is very different thing. So, I hope that you like this particular module, and any questions, again you are free to ask me in a forum. So, I will request a few of my students to show it to you, along with we have called the engineer from Hyundai VEC, Mr. Rajanna, and he will show us how the system operates, but we can also operate independently. It is a very simple and easy system, provided you understand the concept. Alright. So, I'll see you in some other class. Till then, you take care. Bye.
Welcome everyone. Today is the second day of installation of this system. As you can see, we are still trying to set things up, but most of the items have been installed. Yesterday we showed you the internal structure of the electrical wiring. So after that, the people from the company, they have connected the wiring, they have plugged in the power supply. So especially separately for the control panel, you need to give power, as well as for the chamber area, you need a separate power. So for both these, power supplies have been given. And we have kept the chiller unit and the compressor unit outside. You can see a light outside the glass there. So that is the utility room that we have created for the equipment inside the lab. As per safety protocol, As per safety protocol, you should not have gas cylinders, compressors, chiller units, etc. inside the lab. So we have kept it outside in a utility room, and we are taking the tubes and wires from there into our equipment. Chiller unit, as I have told, is for giving sufficient cooling to the coil and the e-beam system, everything, holder, and you saw the crucibles, boats and all. Now what we are trying to do is, if you can see the left side of the instrument. So as you can see, we have completed the most of the tubing required for the functioning of this instrument. So we have done the tubing. This blue tubing is for the air supply. We have done the cooling water in and outlet. These two tubes, if you can touch, I can feel it is cooled. It is coming from the chiller unit outside. So this water supply will take in and take out the water. And we have an exhaust for the rotary pump. As we have spoken yesterday, rotary pump is the roughing pump of the system. So for that exhaust is here. So that is because of safety purposes. It is better that we exhaust this air outside to the utility room, not inside the lab facility. And we have other sections for venting and needle valve inlet, which are yet to be made. So more, but for basic operation, we have made the connections.
These two are the processing gases.
Yes. Yeah, these two are processing gases. The other two are for the purging and creating vacuum, venting, but general gases that are used, like nitrogen compressed air and all. So those connections are made. So we are ready a bit to show you exactly the functioning of the control panel, how vacuum is getting created inside the chamber, and for the e-beam gun, are we getting the plasma and all those things. So once it starts, we will see that.
This is PLNA1. This is PLNA1. PLNA gadget 1, this is a vacuum measuring. This is for measuring chamber vacuum. PLNA2. This is the backing vacuum wall. This is a turbo molecular pumps, so below the. This is a high vacuum wall. High vacuum wall for connecting the chamber.
Chamber from the pump. So we have opened the system because we are going to start it. So he is checking everything inside whether it is fine. So that time it's very difficult to see the inside of this after it starts working. So this is a golden opportunity to see how the valves are connected inside, how is the high vacuum valve looking like, how are the gauges connected. You already saw the pending gauge behind the chamber. Now you have seen the Pirani gauges here, which measure the different vacuum levels. This is actually the heart of the system. The vacuum system is very important. So you can see the system here. You can see the right angle backing valve here. He has told you these are the pinning Pirani gauges, which measure the high vacuums. And the turbo molecular pump is inside. It's a very small pump compared to the roughing pump, as we saw yesterday. So here, where my finger goes, that is where the turbo molecular pump is. And there, next to it, we have the This one is the high vacuum valve. So just now we have shown you the Pirani gauge, the right angle valve, the high vacuum valve, the turbo molecular pump inside. I told you that we have seen the pending gauge, but I am not sure whether we saw it yesterday. So here you can see the pending gauge here. It's called a cold cathode gauge also. So the data for that, like what is the pressure that it is measuring, that comes out through this Ethernet cable that is connected here. This is the gauge that is connected to the chamber. Here is a chamber. The chamber is very, very, very cold because of the, so this line that you are seeing here on the chamber, it has cold water circulation inside. That is for cooling the chamber. So that is there. And this metal piece that you are seeing is grounding. This is grounding between this is door of the chamber. This is the chamber main body. Those two are grounded so as to protect the user. So those things are there. So this cable that you see, let us focus there. So this is the top cover of the chamber. Okay, so here you can see a big black color ribbon here. That big black color ribbon is actually the earthing wire for the chamber. So these are the main things. You can see these tubes. These tubes carry the cooling water inlet and outlet, cold water from the chiller unit for again cooling purposes. And let's see, and remaining when we functionally show you, okay. We will see.
This is graphite crucible. This is for evaporating aluminium, copper, gold, any evaporation material with EB evaporation system.
We have seen the substrate holder rotation before. Now we will see the source rotation. we can see the crucible holder. Now we are changing the speed of the rotation. We are changing the source. So you can see the belt here moving. That changes the crucible. So you can see the belt moving. Now let's look at the crucible. We'll go inside and look at the crucible moving. So you can see here, now it is in one source. Now can you change the source?
Source 4.
Now it is in source 4. We are changing to source 3. Yeah, we are changing to source 2. Now you can see it moving. This is the crucible where we go. Yes, we have shown you the crucible, standard crucibles. The crucibles will come and sit here. This is source rotation. So now the system is almost ready. So to start off, this is the control panel we have explained before. Now what we are trying to do is to create the vacuum inside the chamber. So in that, because it's first time you are operating it, it takes some cycles to arrive at exact timings for arriving at specific vacuum points. So the team here, they will explain like exactly what is involved in this GUI, where we use, this is a human machine interface which can be used to control to a large extent the process.
This is a system will be operating through HMI. This is semi-auto. Up to high vacuum is going for auto cycle. If we go for process, LTHD is going for only manual system. So going to vacuum cycle, this press start button. When press start button, water pump is getting on, the backing on, and the turbo will be on. If it will take time for reaching at turbo speed, 10 to 15 minutes. Once this turbo is ready, you can press the cycle button. When the
turbo is ready?
Turbo is the message is coming, status will be.
You can go along with
it.
So fine pumping means it's a turbo, no?
High vacuum.
So
yeah. Here one switch and turbo oscillator is coming.
Turbo is running. After cycle sequence it will come.
Yeah.
Okay.
When the, so press the cycle button, open roughing valve and reach minus 2 vacuum, chamber vacuum. Once you reach minus 2 vacuum, again go automatically open high vacuum valve. When open high vacuum valve, the pending reading will be start. Pending reading is starting from minus 3 to minus 6 millibar.
Minus 2 also it will read at the engage. Minus 2 to
open. When reach my ultimate vacuum, press the process tab. Process means thermal and iron bombardment. If you press the iron button, it will be hold. Holding is on. Then holding, introduce the gas inlet. Gas by nitrogen laid over. You can switch on the LT, HT, circuit breaker, switch on the switches, LT means HT, create iron movement cleaning. Then iron movement cleaning over 5 to 10 minutes for clean the substrate. Then switch off CB1, HT and switch on LT. This will be during the process, you can switch on the rotary drive, like put it also. By controlling the
radio. You want to see the readings here?
No.
Okay. Okay. At the same time, suppose if you want to see the 3 gauges readings, you go just to system view and in that you can see independent.
All of
the so you can see the entire structure of the system here. What are the different valves?
Mimic diagram.
Rotary,
high vacuum valve, turbo pumps, gate valve, everything.
So whichever is blue in color, that means those valves are on and they are working right. Others, these are not on, that means they are not working. Roughing valve is in off condition, backing valve is in off condition. So roughing valve will be put when we are venting it, right?
This is on.
Okay, this is the high vacuum process. This is the initial pumping process.
Yeah, initial pumping process.
So this IO is when we are operating green color.
Yeah.
So you are telling that before we start all this will be green. So
but still we are in vacuum cycle only. We didn't move to process and
so when we go to process only these things will come green.
Yeah, that has to satisfy. LT we didn't provide a water flow switch for that. For E beacon only main process means for that water source is there, water flow switch is there. That has to satisfy.
Okay, so now we have given power supply only to the control unit, no? EB power supply is not on, right?
There's no switch on. It's alone there, 2 or 3 on.
That is main son, but still we didn't move to process relay.
Okay.
Process.
So when process starts, only we'll switch on the relay?
Yeah. No. When process, after satisfying this interlock and all, it will move to process. No. Next step.
My wife question is, this switch is for the EB power on, no?
Yeah,
no,
so is it on?
For main son and off purpose.
That is on now.
Yeah.
No, so once process, it is ready to do process, these lights will switch on.
Yeah, interlock and set switches will be getting on.
Then we can start the EB control. Yeah. How do we, where do we control the voltage of the EB?
Yeah, here.
Here.
We have to press. Still we didn't turn on. Okay, we have to press on switch. Then we have to select current and high voltage.
This current controller.
So this EB gun will be switched on after we do the iron compartment cleaning, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
So that will be done where? Yes.
Iron compartment not required here for the EB.
Okay.
During LTA, thermal operation, the iron compartment can be used.
So at what pressure will the process thing will start?
It should go minus 5 milliampere, at least minimum minus 5 milliampere.
For EB.
So we have set it inside because at one point this switches will come on, no?
Yeah.
So we have set it inside or it will, why we can control it?
No. One vacuum switch is there and water flow switch is there. That should, all should be satisfied.
Okay.
All should be in NC condition. Then only
So what is the condition for them to get satisfied? Like, have we set it on, already
set? We have to close door switches, all door switches. Shroud, front end, right door of the cabinet and control panel.
Okay.
All doors should be in closed position and vacuum should be in OK.
Okay. So at what point this will turn on now? And when what pressure? It will automatically turn on now?
No, still we are in vacuum condition only. If you move process condition, then only it will turn on.
So now still in 1.9 into minus 4 minimum chamber.
Where this is minus 5 will come.
It will take time actually.
So you can see chamber vacuum here, 1.91 e power minus 4 millibar. It has to reach e power minus 5 for the turbo pump to process to start. So that time only all these things will turn on. So we have to wait for that. As you know, when you create vacuum, as and when we create high vacuum, it becomes even more difficult to create vacuum.
In this, pressure display is there.
Yeah.
Okay, vacuum pressure, roofing pressure, we engage that, clearly mentioned.
What is set clock and set unit?
That is only time. Unit means, so if you want to millibar, you can set millibar, Pascal, like that, or tar. Process speed. Okay, so these are the relays. Relays are not required. So that is not required. This is like service type, service mode type. Process speed. This way. After satisfying the interlock status, we will go to on condition.
Okay, interlock status will turn on. How much time it will take, roughly?
No. We give them some P-store and D-store pressure set point. After reaching that set point.
So what is a set point?
We will set manually. Whichever set point we require. Minus 5.
Have we set it now?
Now for EB we set it minus 5 like that type.
Only for minus 5.
Like that type we have to set.
Close
I mean. Door switch allowed. And what flow switch?
What flow switch check now?
Earlier we saw that these three green buttons were not on. There are set points for water cooling, floor at LPM and safety interlocks where all the doors of the system will be locked properly, the front and back side, everything. Once those things are done, these things will sort of slowly come on. So water cooling has come on. So once they lock everything in the safety doors, this will come on. So the safety interlocks have come on. Now source enabled is depending on the pressure. So it is set at some stop value for the pressure. Once that is reached, the source enabled will come on. When all three are green, we can start the process.